Chairwoman Bonsted, Ranking Member Graves, and members of the committee. I am here today as a member of the U.S. Women's Chamber of Commerce, representing over 500,000 members and millions of American small businesses who are struggling to provide health insurance for themselves, their families, and their employees. The employer-based health care system in this country has become a travesty. It particularly disfavors small and medium-sized businesses that do not represent a large risk pool of insured employees. And it leaves out the self-employed who either go without coverage or are left to seek individual policies where premiums are exorbitant. Costs have been spiraling for small businesses for a number of reasons. Small business premium costs are based upon size, the average age, and the historical health care costs of the employee group. As the employee's age, overall health care costs increase, and small businesses bear increasingly heavy burdens. The effect on small businesses and their employees as a result of spiraling health coverage costs is multifaceted. Many firms simply drop out, no longer able to provide employee health insurance due to costs. This leads to an exodus of good employees seeking employment where health insurance is offered. In the case of my company, we continue to provide coverage, but have asked employees to pick up more of the cost. We are not alone in this practice. As the employees' share of premiums has increased, more employees are opting out of coverage. Today, only 73% of our employees are covered under our company policy. This year, we have asked the employees to pay 60% of the premium payment, thus decreasing their real income. If we ask them to cover even more next year, fewer will remain covered, shrinking the size of our group and thus driving costs up even more, as only those with chronic conditions will opt to continue coverage. Last year, the total cost of coverage for only 11 employees of our company was a whopping 10% of our gross revenues. It ate up every bit of the profit that we should have made and then some. The rate increase last year was a whopping 22%. Even worse, we've been informed as of this morning that the rates are set to increase by another 19% in August of this year. How can health insurance be affordable when an employee earning $300 to $500 per week pays premium coverage for their family at $1,500 per month with a $2,400 deductible and copays as well? How can a small business owner afford $1,500 per month for each of their employees and still stay in business? Frankly, short of any catastrophic health issue, our firm could pay for normal health maintenance for all of our employees for less than we are paying for 73% of our staff now. Age and size discrimination. Small businesses are being forced to discriminate in their hiring practices to continue health insurance coverage for employees as insurance rates begin to increase dramatically for persons over 40. Substantial increasing and unpredictable health care costs for small businesses to delay or cancel new hires. Ideally, the whole existing system should be scrapped and rethought. As it is not practical or politically feasible, I recommend the following. 1. Major reductions of premiums by requiring insurance companies to honestly pool risk among all insured individuals and families. The plan proposed by Senator Baucus, as an example, implementing a national insurance exchange, including a public option, would be a good way to make this happen. However, the public option should be in addition to the private insurance to provide choice and competition. 2, ensuring all Americans are covered to spread the cost is desirable, as it would potentially drop rates. However, mandates are not an option, as it would force many small businesses to close their doors completely. Affordability is essential, and tax incentives for small businesses should be included. 3, streamline the processes through information technology. 4, limit the ability of insurance companies to deny coverage. Primary physicians and specialists know that their patients, they know their history, and know what best care they should receive. Finally, over the past several years, the competition between health insurance companies has decreased as a result of mergers. Fewer health insurance companies create less competition, resulting in higher premiums. It is government responsibility to establish guidelines for equality for the good of all. Small businesses, health care providers, and insurance providers, as long as the system we are currently have continues to be utilized. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Our next witness, Mr.